The LA Rams had a chance to win the NFC West last week and advance to the postseason for the first time in over a decade, but couldn't come away with a very crucial win against the Arizona Cardinals. It was a winnable game for sure, but when your quarterback turns the ball over four times like Jared Goff did last week, it's kind of hard to come away with a win. But the offense had some big plays that week, and we're hoping some of those big plays cross over into this Week 14 road matchup against the Houston Texans. We're coming out wearing our throwback uniforms this week, looking for a little bit of luck as we saw my first kick return of the season last week. Can I get one to get Week 14 underway as the Texans get us going? And this kick will be returned from inside the 5-yard line at about the 3, bringing this one right up the middle, making one man miss on a juke move, and finally brought down at the 24-yard line. So can the Rams get this ball down the field? Jared Goff's the man who has to focus this week. Threw 3 interceptions last week. He's up to 10 on the season with 29 touchdowns. Hasn't been a bad season for Jared Goff at all, but when you're throwing interceptions in bunches, it does not help out the team. 1st and 10, and Todd Gurley getting started as he picks up actually no yards on that carry. 2nd and 10 for the Rams, still in the shotgun. Jared Goff will draw it back to pass this time, looks across the middle. There goes the first catch of the game. I only had 2 for 38 yards last week, essentially getting shut down. There goes 1 for 11. And now we take a look at the Houston defense, and it starts with their front 7. J.J. Watt, Quinn Copeland's coming off the edge. Our tackles will be very busy today. Whitney Merciless, Brian Cushing, and Jadeveon Clowney, and then the secondary, Jonathan Joseph, Jahleel Adai, Raheem Moore Sr., and LaMarcus Joyner. 3rd down for the Rams, 1st 3rd down of the game, as Goff will look left side, throws for Gurley, that pass is off his helmet. Gurley not turning around in time, and luckily that ball goes into the turf, because that could have been picked off by several Houston defenders. Got to keep your head on a swivel. Clowney nearly got the pick fair. Gurley tried to dive for, so did another Houston defender, but luckily it's 4th down. The Rams went the ball away, and our defense gets their first stop of the game. So 1st and 10 for the Rams, starting from the 24-yard line again, and a throw right side for Gage Carver on the slant route, working against Jonathan Joseph. Nice grab by Carver. 1st down, Rams. Gage Carver also didn't get the football too much last week in Arizona. It was a very weird game. We had a lot of big plays, but not a lot of short ones. As it's now 2nd and 8, Rams going with the ground game. Todd Gurley up the middle, and he'll get us to near midfield, a 4-yard gain. And it's going to be hard to run today, but we got to get something going early on and build on it throughout the game. Another 3rd down for the Rams, 3rd down and 3. Goff throws my way, the Rams convert, and we're in Houston territory up to their 42-yard line. There goes my 3rd grab of the game, already beating last week's reception total. 2nd and 8 from the 40-yard line, going to the ground game. Stretch outside for Gurley, and he can't get around Merciless. He's brought down, 4-yard loss that time, as Gurley's looking at 1 yard a carry, and all of a sudden it's 3rd down and 12. Goff in the shotgun, drops back, looks right side, has a man that is going to be complete for a 3-yard gain. Nowhere near the 1st down, 4th down for the Rams. We will punt the ball again, and Houston driving back down the field. They had a touchdown. Rams back on the field from the 24-yard line. Every drive starting from the 24. There goes Gage Carver in open space, making one man miss, and he's brought down at the 42-yard line again. Can you say deja vu? Goff under center on 1st down. Rams will go jet sweep right side, trying to get around the edge. Good blocking on the edge by Gage Carver, able to get away from one defender, but pushed out after a 4-yard gain. And this is what the Rams need to do, keep this Houston defense off balance. Now facing 3rd down and 7, Goff dropping back out of the shotgun, gets pressured up the middle, but finds a man, that's Cabrera. And Cabrera trying to make a spin move happen, did not work there, but a 1st down for the Rams up to the Houston 38-yard line. And Cabrera, what a move off the line of scrimmage. And then the spin move that, well, didn't work. Good job, though. Getting closer to field goal range, 1st down from the 38-yard line. Kendrick's the man in motion. As we go back to the ground with Todd Gurley, he finds a little lane there and picks up 3 yards, but still not a lot of room to run. 8 yards and 8 carries for Todd Gurley. 2nd down and 7, Goff looking downfield, has a man that's going to be complete. The Rams pick up a 1st down, and that is Kenny Britt across the middle. Rams inside the red zone. We'll go 4 wide on 1st down. Jared Goff rolling out to his left, throws on the run in the traffic, and is picked off by Brian Cushing. This happened last week. You can't throw on the run across your body into traffic. You have to take care of the ball in the red zone, and now Houston has the ball at the 14-yard line, and they have a chance to make it a 2-score game. And honestly, Jared Goff could have kept running here. He could have kept running up the middle, but instead threw it. And I don't know if that was for me or Gage Carver, but Brian Cushing with the pick, and it's luckily still a 7-point ball game. So our defense getting the job done, 1st and 10, cutting up the seam, but Jared Goff going outside for Gage Carver. And a good completion up to the 45-yard line. 8-yard gain that time. Going to the ground game on 2nd and short. Gurley with a carry, and Gurley finds 2 yards but can't find the 1st down. It's 3rd down and 1. Can we get the ground game going on 3rd down? Goff give to Gurley. Gurley up the middle. Gurley finds the first down. 3 yard gain up to midfield. And we got a chance to at least get three here inside the 2 minute warning. Ball at the 45 yard line. Third down once again. But Goff fires across the middle and finds Kenny Britt for a short gain. Going no huddle though. First down and 10. We'll go screen left side. Good throw from Goff on time. And the Rams will get out of bounds. I thought I did, but the clock's still running there. Now facing third and one. Clock stopped at a minute 21. And the Rams could get a first down here. We're expecting a Houston blitz. They don't bring it in. Goff throws out of bounds, but Gurley was wide open on the check down. Jared Goff is making mistakes that are costing us points in this ball game, and he missed a wide open Todd Gurley who wasn't even being covered. All of a sudden, now it's a 14-3 ball game, and the Rams will have a chance to return this one. This will be returned from inside the end zone, and I'm bringing this one out. I had a big-time return last week, and I can't get the same thing going here in week 14. But the Rams starting from the 23-yard line with 12 seconds on the clock and three timeouts, we still have a chance. Lining up in the pistol, going jet sweep left side. Good block on the edge by Faria. There goes the speed on display. Pass to Dye down the sideline, and the Houston Texans can't stop the touchdown. The Rams will make it a one-score ball game. And all it took was 10 seconds off the clock, 77 yards to the end zone on the jet sweep. How am I really not the number one player on the MVP rankings right now? We see this kind of play all the time. And you know what they say? Speed kills, and the Houston Texans just paid for not respecting that speed. Big time play before the end of the first half, and our defense with a good stop to begin the second half as we're still down by 4 points starting from the 11-yard line. Goff looking to throw on first down, and we'll just throw this one out of bounds as I guess no one was open on the play. Now facing second down and 10. Everyone enclosed. Goff will throw once again. Looks left side for Kenny Britt, and Britt with the grab picks up 14 yards and a Rams first down. He's been kind of quiet the past couple of weeks with Jeffrey Cabrera taking a lot of snaps from him, but a good job by Kenny Britt getting separation and getting that reception. Ball at the 32-yard line, second and three, giving the ball back to Ty Gurley. He finds the lane and finds the first down, but is brought down very quickly by J.J. Watt. But another third down for the Rams, third and one from the 47-yard line. Houston brings everyone on the blitz. No one accounts for the receivers. And a quick pass on the out route for a Rams first down. We're up to the 43, now facing third and six from the 39. We'll go play action. Goff looking downfield. We'll throw it into double coverage, and I can't come away with the reception. And Jared Goff made this throw. I mean, he just didn't read this play properly. Look at Kenny Britt. This play was designed for Britt. It was cover one. I knew that from the snap, and he wasn't looking for the wide open man. So we punt the ball back to Houston. Houston goes three and out. They give the ball back to us, and a beautiful punt by Schmidt. This one to go out inside the 5-yard line at our three. So a long drive coming up for the Rams, and there's still time for us to get the lead back in this game. 103 left in the third quarter. And we'll start with the ground game, trying to avoid some type of freak sack as Todd Gurley had a hard time running today. 13 carries and only 21 yards. We'll throw on second down. Goff looks right side. He's got a man. That's Gage Carver with the first down. And we're up to the 15-yard line. That's a 12-yard gain. When in doubt, throw the football. Second and 10 for the Rams. Fourth quarter getting underway. We go back to the ground with Todd Gurley. He finds a lane this time and gets near the first down marker. 10-yard gain up to the 25-yard line. And a lot of those running yards you're seeing are from my big run down the field. Third niches for the Rams. Give to Todd Gurley once again. And Gurley will find the first down. 3 yard gain. We'll keep this clock ticking and we'll keep this possession going. Inside of 9 minutes, Jared Goff looks right side once again. Has a man. That's Gage Carver working inside again. And this drive hasn't gone too shabby so far. There goes Gage Carver. 7th reception of the game for 79 yards. The rookie's trying to get this team back in the lead. First and 10, Goff throws under pressure from J.J. Watt. He nearly gets sacked there. Good job getting the ball away. And now facing second down and 10. Rams lining up on the pistol. Jared Goff dropping back. The pass would have moved off the line of getting away from Joyner into the open field. The Rams will score and take the lead with 6:49 to go. This play was ran to perfection. And Jared Goff was paying attention this time, found the open man. What a move off the line. Look at the footwork here. Look at Joseph leaning. And then making the move inside, good accurate throw from Jared Goff, and then breaking into the open field, and then the Rams add a touchdown. It just does not get any better than that. Big time score for the Rams, but can our defense get a stop and keep us in this game? They can't do it. 21-17, 4:52 to go. the Rams have a chance to get this lead back down by 4 points again, and not a bad carry from Todd Gurley, 16 carries and 39 yards. Second and five for the Rams. Goff throws left side, nearly picked off as he's looking for Gage Carver. Got to get that out earlier. Now facing third down and five, 4:23 on the clock. Lining up in the shotgun will go four wide. Goff throws across the middle. There goes Kenny Britt again, and Kenny Britt picks up 6 yards. Rams up to the 36-yard line. Still a lot of time left in the game, trying to make this the last possession of this fourth quarter. Going to the ground game with Todd Gurley. He loses the football, but luckily we recover. But we're facing third and 10. Long third down situations have not been kind to us this game. Gurley got away from Cushing, but in that spin move attempt, he spun a little too much and the ball came loose. Luckily, we recovered, but now facing third and 10, 3:20 left in the ball game, and the Rams will go five wide. Jared Goff will drop back, quickly throws my way. That pass is going to be nearly brought in for the first down. I had it against the first defender, and then the second one came in and knocked the ball loose. Fourth down for the Rams. Do we even think about going for it here, or do we trust the defense to get a stop? We'll trust the defense, and maybe it was the wrong decision as their offense runs out the rest of the clock. The Rams don't retake the field in offense, and we lose this game 21-17, and it's our second two-game skid of the season as all of a sudden we're now 9-4. A couple of weeks ago, we were sitting high and pretty in the division with a three-game lead, and all of a sudden that lead has gone away as we just can't manage to get these wins against teams on the road. I mean, we're not playing well on the road at all, and it really came down to a lack of a ground game and Jared Goff's mistakes, missing open receivers, interceptions that didn't need to happen. And honestly, Houston played a pretty good game. I mean, you see Osweiler here, 3 touchdowns, 1 INT, Lamar Miller, good game on the ground. And through the air, Hopkins, Devon, and Fuller got the job done. And I really feel like this game came down to that red zone INT by Jared Goff. We at least got a field goal there. We would have been in better shape for the rest of this game. And it wasn't like we were bad on third down. 61% is pretty good. That's actually above the league average. And gaining a lot of XP from this last week's game, although we didn't get the win. And in week 15, the Rams are on the road once again, taking on 9-4 Tennessee. And right now, it is the Seahawks with the number one ranking in the division. They own a tiebreaker. I'm not exactly sure what the tiebreaker is, but the Rams 7-0 at home and 2-4 on the road, 4-2 in the division. 3 games left on the schedule, Titans, Colts, and Saints. We need wins in all three of those games because things are looking like they're going to go down to the wire, and we're taking on former wide receiver for the LA Rams, Tavon Austin. And despite what seems like good play, I'm slowly falling down the MVP rankings. I'm now number 10. Jared Goff is also going to fall off as well. And because of that last game, that drop, I decided to add +2 to my catching traffic and another one to my release. And so up next, the LA Rams taking on the team that played in the Super Bowl from the AFC side last season against the Arizona Cardinals, the Tennessee Titans. Marcus Mariota playing some great football at this point in his career, and they have some weapons to work with. So the Rams need a big rebound game in week 15. Can we get the job done and retake control of our division and get into the playoffs for the first time since 2003. Thank you all for tuning in. Hope you enjoyed the episode. If you enjoyed, make sure to leave a like and also subscribe if you're new. And I will see you all in the next episode. See you then. Have a nice day.